I'm Marla. What do I think of the Azores as a whale watch destination? I think you're the luckiest people in the world. You have resident sperm whales and a beautiful landscape, and it's a really nice perspective on the island to get people out on the water this way, like looking back on the land and then just, you know, without going very far from your home base to be able to see so many different species. You're lucky.
Hello, I'm Franny. What do I think of the Azores as a whale watching destination? Well, I think it's pretty magical and does not seem real. I never thought that a place could exist with sperm whales just hanging around all the time. That is a truly unique experience for anybody. If you've seen many, many whales, or if you've never seen a whale before in your life, a once-in-a-lifetime whale viewing opportunity.
We're pretty lucky people, her and I, because we get to work in the polar regions where there's lots of whales, but I also have the pleasure of spending many months of the year on the Canadian coast, on the Pacific side, with whales that are primarily California gray whales and humpback whales, and we have three different ecotypes of killer whales there. It's very different from here. It's very different. We also experience resident whales, but not in the same capacity of your year-round sperm whales and the dolphin species that you have. In comparison to here, I think you have a much more open perspective. Like you leave your harbor here and you are immediately in open ocean. For us at home, we have also archipelagos of islands, but things are tighter and closer, and inlets and passageways that are super different landscape compared to here. It was such a pleasure today to be out in completely open horizon like that and have that kind of perspective to be able to look back on San Miguel. The opportunity to see this place differently, I think, is probably one of the best reasons just to get out on the boat, regardless of what you see. But I think similarly for myself at home and you guys here, I think it's, you never really know what you're going to get. Things are a little bit transient, but there's really nutrient-rich water, so you have opportunities that can really bring you great surprises, but you'll never see anything if you don't get on the boat at all. So you must go in both places.